All right. So I've had a lot of people ask me what it is like to actually give a TED Talk. And I think a lot of my friends wanted to know because they thought it's got to be the most terrifying thing in the world, right? You're on a big stage, there's a huge audience, but maybe more importantly than that, you're being video recorded in high definition. And this is actually being live streamed to people that subscribe to TED. And then ultimately, there's a chance that your talk will end up on TED.com, where it will be viewed by potentially hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of people. So certainly on the surface, it seems like it could be a terrifying thing. And if that got into your head, that could really mess up your ability to speak and perform and all that good stuff. So I have to say that I do speak publicly frequently, something I like to do. So I kind of went into it armed with that sort of ability, but I definitely was nervous. This was the largest scale talk I'd ever given. And, you know, obviously there's a huge production behind it, so that was also intimidating. But I will say, my reaction to actually giving the talk was completely different than what I thought it would be. So I expected to be very nervous, as anyone I think would expect to be. And that, you know, it would be one of those situations where, you know, like on old school, Will Ferrell blacks out, can't remember giving the speech. That's kind of what I thought might happen. Which, you know, happened to me when I first started giving talks. And I think most academics that give talks, maybe that happens to them in the beginning. But what actually happened was that I was completely calm. I was extremely excited, but I was not anxious. I didn't have anxiety, and it was the most present I think I've ever been for any public speaking engagement. And the reason I think that that happened is because it was such a big production that it ended up feeling a little less like all the pressure was on me, and more like I was a cog in a wheel that, you know, the TED conference, and that I just needed to do my part, and that I had a whole team behind me supporting me. And that's totally true. Not only was there an extensive audiovisual team, just, you know, leading industry professionals in that space that backed up the talks and were recording the talks and making sure everything looked really good and was very professional, but I also had a whole crew of fellow speakers that I became very close friends with, and there was a lot of camaraderie there. So I've never performed really, certainly not in plays or anything like that, but I suspect it's similar to what you might feel if you perform on Broadway, or any kind of big stage production. It's beyond you. It's this sort of, you're just one part of a bigger production. And so that made it really less stressful for me, and it was amazing. I mean, it was amazing. It was one of the coolest things I've ever done in my life. Having that kind of an audience, this was in Arusha, Tanzania, by the way, was where TED Global 2017 was this past August. You know, an incredibly impressive international audience, lots of really powerful people and also philanthropic people that just care about what you have to say. So having that kind of audience is rare in life, maybe a once in a lifetime kind of opportunity. And it was just exhilarating. It was extremely exciting giving that talk. And I'm incredibly thankful for having the opportunity. And I would recommend other scientists, if you have the opportunity to be involved in any kind of TED events, for example, TEDx, they're independently organized TED events, they happen all over the world, take that opportunity because it's such a unique speaking platform. It will challenge you in ways that you would not otherwise be challenged. And I think you'll inevitably be grateful that you had the opportunity.